We don't know. It was so surreal. I remember being on the field, like, in the last game, and just, like, when they kept scoring, like, 4, 5, 6 goals, like, we were looking at each other, and it was like the Twilight Zone. It just felt so odd. It felt like, you know, nothing was going to go our way. Anything bad that could happen did happen.
Yeah, like, we're playing lacrosse, games matter, but when we play this team, it's a bloodbath, it's a war. It's, you go out there and you die for your brothers, you go out there and you die for yourself, you go out there and you play for everything that matters. Like, nothing else matters but that game at that moment in time. So, losing to them is the worst feeling in the world.
Takes to pull off a trip like this to put you in a place other than a hotel where you guys can be together as bros, like it's a lot to pull off. And we were just talking about, man, we love doing this because we get paid $100,000 a year to do it. But we do it because we love God. It's altruism. It's just this word altruism. I hope you guys all catch it. Altruism is just giving back and not expecting anything in return. It's just you do things because you have a good heart. You love because that's what great men do. They love their spouses. They love their children. They do whatever it takes for those people they love most to succeed altruistically. I mean, that translates to the field. It translates to our greatness. And guys, we are going to have a lot of fun this year on the lacrosse field. And we're also going to have a lot of fun just being bros.
every year, FGCU is at the end of the schedule, end of our schedule. It's the last game of the year. And this year was our home field, under the lights, Saturday night. Everybody's there, conference championship, who's first or second, and it's such a big hype for everyone.
It was honestly the craziest thing. I mean, I've never seen kids on our team so hyped up about one game.
We began to realize that every game was an opportunity for our family to stay together longer. And so, all of a sudden, you know, every ground ball turned into an opportunity for our family to stay together longer. Every, you know, defensive stand was an opportunity for our family to stay together longer, because as long as we kept winning games, the longer our season would last.
Oh yeah. Break guys, into that. Break
hey,
into
remember
that.
Guys, hey, if you love playing together, you're gonna have a great time tonight. Don't get down on each other. You just love playing with one another. You get that chemistry going. You make a great assist, you make a great goal. Come together and celebrate. Have fun. If you guys are enjoying it, you guys are gonna play great. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Trust me. If you guys are having fun, you're gonna kill it.
Your feet! Right! Right! You're going to show each other why you're family right now.
Let's go.
Go 110 miles an hour and give it 100% for each other.
Next question. Okay, after the game. Are we rolling?
I've never felt something as powerful as when the last second ticked down. And to be honest, I broke down and cried. That was a moment where I knew that things were different, in a way where I knew that, like, all the brotherhood and all the practices and all the blood, sweat, and tears we put into the season finally clicked. Because that's where it shined, when that moment ticked down and we won, and I saw all the young freshmen run on the field because they knew how important it was.
We have a bunch of people from different places, from different backgrounds, from, you know, from different ideas that come together and mesh together to form one unit. And it's, you know, we always talk about one team together, and it's like we have all these different people and different places in their lives forming this one team. In one family, and that's, you know, such a beautiful, beautiful thing.
Reinhardt. I don't know. Nobody was on the same page, and we just didn't click. And credit to Reinhardt. I mean, they killed it. They were together. They played great. They went to the Nationals, they did pretty well.
Yeah, we didn't take care of business. It's that simple.
There's times we go through hard times, and then we have to be there for one another. And we've talked about the struggles that we go through as brothers. So there'll be brokenness in your life. But after brokenness, the hope is that you come to blessing, and that there's a blessing in your life. And after you're blessed, and you learn from the darkness, you learn from the brokenness, then you can give your life to other people in an altruistic way because you've been there. And so when you walk with younger brothers and sisters in your life, you can walk with them in deeper places in the darkness with them, and you can talk about it and go there because you've been there. So, but there's times when you go through the darkness and you taste the darkness, and it doesn't taste good, but you know and you hope and you pray that there's a way out. A lot of times, it's the brothers that walk with you and come with you into the darkness.
So, in terms of, you know, what happens next year, that comes down to the off season, but I'll tell you, there's a fire lit in every single one of these guys right now.
There's another redemption for us. There's something else we have to strive for, and I know we can. And we're always gonna remember that game is the game that, you know, tore us down but built us up at the same time.
Season.
What's up?
Sorry. His chair's so good. Like, I literally just go like this. Like, I'm comfortable doing this. Okay.
Ow! Dude, why? Dude, that was... away from you. It's hard, bro.
What's up, dude?
Is that you?
And cut.
Get that out of my face.